funny. I'm serious. Okay? No, Darlene wouldn't tell me. This is really important. Oscar and Wade, they told me. So now I have 11. Okay? And I want 12. I want a dozen.
Okay.
All right. So, now, you don't have to be exact, you know. Just give me a rough estimate.
Rough estimate?
Yeah.
50
blowjobs? Are you sure? Because, I mean, that, it sounds kind of low.
No, 50 men.
Whoa, okay, see, now we're talking dick. Okay, so let's just say on an average, you blew each guy 10 times. That's, wait.
Hey, Freddy.
What?
Can we talk about something besides blowjobs, Richie?
Well, what else is there to talk about?
Well, we could talk about politics.
No, I don't care about politics. No, sorry. Okay, so 50 times 10, I'm gonna put you down for an even 500, okay? You know, give or take a few squirts.
Okay.
Tuesdays
and Thursdays.
I go to college.
Don't look like a college girl.
I'm the emancipated type. Real emancipated.
No, I didn't mean that. Whatever that means. I mean, you just don't look young enough.
I'm not.
So why go to college?
Got nothing else to do on
Tuesdays and Thursdays.
What are you doing the other day?
I drink.
Hey?
Lulu? Are you okay?
Fine.
Did you take your meds, sweetie?
Yep.
Eddie, name's Eddie.
The name should be Eddie. What should my name be?
I don't know. What would you like it to be?
I'd like it to be what it is. Sarah has a biblical ring.
You want to know what to mean?
Lulu? Are you sure you're okay, sweetie? Maybe we should have
you.
You
please leave me alone now?
God. What are you staring at? Huh?
Would that be considered conduct unbecoming for an undercover cop?
Day in the Nashville area and the rest.
Let's get us a bottle.
No.
Get the scotch.
What do you want me to do? Just step out in the alley? Is that it?
No.
What are you laughing at?
Nothing. I was just remembering something that happened a long time ago.
Well, I'm gonna go to bed. You coming?
Yeah, I'll be there in a second.
you been all day?
At school.
Oh, I forgot.
You were asleep when I left.
You didn't wake you.
Did you go out?
Did you go out?
Yeah, I went out for a little while.
Well, why don't you just go out again so we can enjoy the movie?
Why don't you blow me, babe?
Nice talk.
Nice talk.
Thanks.
Come on, big boy.
This is our movie. We go tomorrow night.
Left my wallet and the other purse. Do you have any cash?
Yeah, but look.
Isn't that great? I mean, it's neat.
You already have 3 copies at home.
Yeah, but none in paperback.
Okay, so buy it.
I will. There you go.
Thank you. I'll be over by the Coke guy.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Say, you a writer?
Yeah, I've got a story here, actually. First published in the Missouri Review.
I'm impressed.
Actually, it's my first time in print.
Really? What else you read?
Magnetic North.
No.
Wednesdays at 9 is a sci-fi thing. I wrote the pilot.
Oh, TV. I don't watch TV.
Actually, I don't either.
I hear you. Yo.
Oh, yeah. Hold on. Yo.
Thanks.
Hello?
I'm trying to reach a Mr. Ben Clifton.
That's me.
Mr. Clifton, hello. My name is Linda Davis. I am the head therapist at 16 Valley View Lane. One of our patients, Lulu McAfee, has...
Lulu?
Yes. So you do know Lulu?
Well, yeah, I used to. What? Why?
She left last night on an unauthorized outing. And I'm afraid she hasn't come back yet.
How did you get my number?
Well, actually, you are listed as a contact person, one of her old files.
I'm not going to get involved here. I want that understood right now.
No, No one is asking you to get involved, Mr. Clifton. I'm just asking you to notify us should she happen to get in touch with you. Lulu has, she's actually been doing quite well. There was talk of getting her an apartment maybe next year and...
Look, we haven't talked in a long time, but if I hear from her, I will let you know.
No luck, huh? Well, maybe she joined the blowjob squad. Because they're all over, Linda. Yeah, I mean, there's packs of these lonely and restless women, and they're roaming the streets of every city in America. And they're looking for new members.
I don't think so, Freddie.
Hello. Hello.
Who was it?
Nobody. They just hung up.
What do you want me to tell you? People don't want to watch a show about an oncologist. They just don't. It's a bummer.
You know, Clark, I don't understand you. You were the one who's incessantly going on about how people are desperate for something real. Well, this is it, man. We've got a chance to do something special here to make people feel something.
People don't want to feel. They want to be entertained. Look, If you're ER and you're scoring a 22 share, you can write about brain tumors and mastectomies. But that's just not where we're at here. You're gonna have to come up with something else.
Like what?
I don't know. Make him a dentist.
A dentist?
An architect, a plumber. I don't care what the fuck he is, all right?
You gotta help me here a tiny bit, please.
You're getting paid to do a job. Do it.
I want to see new pages Wednesday.
Wednesday?
Wednesday.
This is bullshit. Hello, Clifton. I actually think I'm a little early.
Do you want to have a drink at the bar while you wait?
Sure. Hey. Can I get a diet? Double vodka on the rocks. Yeah, hello.
Faulkner used to drink right across the street.
Who is this?
Faulkner, Fitzgerald, Nathaniel West. All of your heroes, they used to drink right around here. Ben?
Lulu.
They drank and they laughed and they argued just like we used to do.
What do you want, Lulu?
I want you to find me, Ben. It's been a really long time, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. So, where are you right now?
I'll be in the bar. Please, Ben, just find me.
Here you go. Thanks.
Sir, your script.
Thanks.
Where am I? I'm in Hollywood across from Musso's.
What are you doing there? We said we were going to meet at Helena's.
Yeah, I know, but I'm having kind of a weird day.
Ben, are you meeting me here for lunch or not?
No.
What's going on?
Lulu's here, Claire.
She's in L.A.?
Why?
And listen, I really can't get into this right now. I will call you later, okay?
Wait, Ben.
What are you staring at, sweetheart?
I'm sorry, I thought you were somebody else.
Take a hike.
Hi, Lulu.
You found me.
Yep.
You look different. I mean, not way different, just different. So maybe it's your hair.
It's definitely shorter.
You're still the handsomest guy in the world. You haven't aged a minute.
And you're a liar.
What about me? How do I look?
You look fine, Lulu.
Fine. I don't look beautiful or pretty or anything like that. Well, I know I look a hell of a lot better than the last time you saw me. 16 years ago. Have you been? Been?
Okay. Lulu. I talked to Linda Davis, and she is really worried about you. So I thought I'd... Don't play it, right?
No.
Give me the letter. Give me the... Please, give me... No.
Okay. Fuck me first.
No. Give me the letter.
Fine.
Dear Mr. Clifton, we are very pleased to inform you that you have a place in our 1982 Iowa Writers' Workshop. Raymond Carver, Richard Yates, they're both...
But what about a road trip?
Lulu, we'll do it. It's just going to have to wait a little while.
Well, until when?
Lulu, it's only going to be 1 year we'll be separated. It's not a big deal.
Don't go.
Don't go? Why? Wait, are you serious? Don't go, no, I'm not going to give up my dream, Lulu.
Oh, you'll give me up, right?
No, no way, never.
It was 1982. That's when we met. That was a great summer, wasn't it? Whole lives ahead of us unlived. Remember? And then one day, I stepped out of the sunlight. You left me alone in the dark.
Yeah, well, you know, a lot has changed, Lulu.
But that doesn't mean that we can't go back.
Go back where?
Go back to where we can start again.
Lulu, you know that can't happen.
Sure it can, Ben, if we want it to again.
No, it can't happen. You know it can't, Lulu.
What has happened to you? What happened to the Ben that I knew? The Ben that never would take no for an answer. Where did the boy go? The boy who used to sleep outside my dorm room window and cry because I wanted to break up with him. What happened to him? He wouldn't accept the word no. What happened to the guy who was going to write the big, great American novel at the big table? What happened to that guy? What happened to the Ben who made a sacred vow with me to squeeze every little fucking thing that we could out of life? Remember? What happened to him? Did he just write for TV now?
Lulu, I did not come here to be abused in public by a...
By what? By a mental patient? Is that what you're gonna say? By a crazy person? Go ahead, say it. Mental patient.
Yeah, so what? I've done a stint in the bin myself. It's better than killing yourself, huh? At least you get some rest, huh?
Thank you for your input. Let's go.
I guess we're leaving now. Bye, everybody. Where are we going?
I am taking you home.
No. How about if I take you to meet our son?
talking about our son.
You heard me.
We don't have a son.
Where's your car?
Right there. Talk to me.
Yes, we have a son. So come on. Come with me. Let's take a road trip.
We're not taking a road
trip. Yeah, you and me and you, Ben. Come on. We'll blast across the desert and we'll ride the thermals east like a pair of fucking eagles. Come on.
Lulu, don't mess with me, please.
I'm not messing with you. I had a baby.
You had a baby?
Mm-hmm.
How?
Okay, I'll bite, Lulu. That's possible. Anything's possible. Anything could have happened in the last 15 years.
Your baby, Ben.
That is not possible. That is bullshit, Lulu. Get off the car. Get in. Just get in.
Oh. 6 pounds, 7 ounces. Boy. This is him. 6 years ago. And this is his birth certificate. Martin Ellsworth, June 6, 1983. And his parents are Jerome Ellsworth. He's a European history professor, and his mother is a chemist. Her name's Millie. And I didn't put your name down there because I wanted to protect your privacy.
June 6th. His birthday's in 3 days.
Yeah, that's why I'm here. Because I made an agreement with the Ellsworths that I could see him when he turned 16. So it would be legal. We could see him now.
You know, you could be making all this up. This picture could have come from anywhere. This could be a total fabrication.
Lulu. I can't get involved here.
Keep it. He's your son.
I'm sorry, Lulu.
Who are you calling?
Calling Linda Davis.
No! I am not going back there. We're going cross country. We are going to chase the speed of light and claim our boy.
Lulu? Is that you?
Hey, what's going on?
What, your voice, it sounds all muffled. Are you giving someone a blowjob? You're not? Oh. Well, thank goodness. What? Oh, I don't know. Are you sure? Okay. Yeah, I'll try. Okay.
Professor Ellsworth.
What?
Professor Ellsworth. Go ahead.
Hello.
Hello, this is Jerome Ellsworth, and what Lulu told you was true. That's correct. She called last week to say that she was coming.
This is a pretty big surprise. Does he...
Yes, absolutely. He's expecting you. You see, our agreement was that if she wanted to see him, she could, provided that she was well enough, which she certainly seems to be. Of course, I'm I'm not a psychiatrist, you know. Okay, very good. We will see you in a few days then. Bye now.
Bye. Freddy? Freddy, who are you talking to?
No one. It was the wrong number. Yeah, I just borrowed these and put them. Yeah. I didn't take that. I don't know where it is. Oh, I'm sorry. I don't know anything.
Fuck me anytime real soon, forget about it.
You know what? I've got to make a phone call.
To who?
My wife.
Pussy whipped.
Are you guys going anywhere near New Mexico?
We're going to Flagstaff.
Hello.
Claire, it's me.
Oh, my God, Ben. Where have you been? I've been trying to reach you all day.
I'm in the desert.
What do you mean in the desert?
We are somewhere between Victorville and Las Vegas.
Where? You and...
Lulu. I'm with Lulu. Lulu! Shit!
Who was that dude?
Just some guy I picked up.
Yeah? He didn't look like he was hitching to me.
I didn't say he was hitching, I said I picked him up.
Where?
Amarillo, where I was dancing topless at the Teddy Bear Lounge.
So where are you headed?
Will you stop asking me questions, please? Because it could make me extremely paranoid. And believe me, you do not want to have that happen.
Do you want me to come up front?
No, I don't want you to come in the fucking front. Jesus Christ. I think you better get out of the car before I get seriously pissed.
You know something? You're a very strange chick.
You have no idea. Kiss me now if you want.
Unbelievable.
Okay. I have cried enough tears to wash my dishes. I have paced all the roads in my heart. They're all dusty
abandoned and deserted. How'd I come to this ghost town? You were not one to show me your feelings, and by that, I guess I should have known. When I knocked, I was hoping you'd answer. There was spiritually nobody home. All these wells are out of water. And the sun.
Separate rooms.
114.
Where are you?
112.
I got it. Thank you. Ben, what did you tell Claire?
I told her the truth.
You told her where we were going? You told her about Martin?
Yeah, I told her everything. She's my wife. She's got a right to know.
But you're still here, aren't you? I bet she's not too happy about that.
Good night, Lulu.
Now there's only one light on the main street, and there's really nobody around. Well, I thought you'd be like an old western, but you were only a ghost.
Do you live in Chicago?
No.
You're traveling on business?
Nope. My husband's on his way to Madison, Wisconsin. I'm meeting him there.
Huh.
Okay. He's with his old college flame. They're driving across country. By the way, my name's Claire.
Claire? My name's Lou.
Mm. Nice to meet you. So what kind of work do you do, Lou? If I may be so forward to ask.
I'm in advertising. Mm.
Too bad, wrong occupation.
Why? What are you looking for?
Oh, professional hitman.
Can't help you there.
Shame.
Who are you looking to get rid of?
Oh, my husband.
Maybe we could ask the pilot to make an announcement. See if somebody on board can help you out.
Oh, you mean like a terrorist in between assignments?
Yeah. Or maybe a serial killer with some downtime.
That would be excellent.
So what do you do, Claire, when you're not plotting?
I'm a psychiatrist. Yeah. Can I have another vodka straight up?
Okay.
Make that a double.
Anything for you, sir?
Yeah, I'll have the same.
Right away.
You don't mind if I get drunk, do you, Lou?
You don't mind if I join you?
Be my guest.
You were talking in your sleep.
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were. I could hear you through the wall.
Lulu, you're being silly. You know that.
Look
guy is watching us.
He's reading his newspaper.
Yeah, now he is reading a newspaper. Before, he was staring a hole into my head. He's following us, you know.
Lulu, he is not. I'm driving.
Yes. I'm gonna go over there and talk to him.
No, you are not. No, please, please sit down.
I fooled you, didn't I? What did you think I was going off on some kind of paranoid, delusional state, right?
This is not
you
funny, Lulu.
You should see the look on your face.
It's not funny.
Oh, it's not funny, Lulu. It's not funny.
I gotta gas up the car. Be right back.
Don't even think about it.
Me? Are you talking to me?
That's it. That's it. That's it. Why are you following me? I am sick and tired of it. Do you understand? I don't want you to follow me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Where is the camera? Give me the camera. Where is the fucking camera? Okay, is it over here? No. What are you laughing at? I'll give you one more chance. Give me the camera. The camera! Jesus Christ! Hey! I'm tired of you guys following me! Do you understand? Just leave me the fuck alone! Just leave me the fuck alone! Do you get it?
Just calm down, okay? Let's go. I'm sorry.
Don't bother. Just get her away from me.
I'm sorry. All right, let me get this real clear. You're a shrink. She's a mental patient?
Certified.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Wait, it gets better.
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
Listen to this. Okay? Get ready.
Yeah.
I just found out. They had a child together back in 83 that Ben never knew about. Okay? She gives him up for adoption while she's in a mental institution, and that's why they're going back to Madison now, is to see him for the first time.
That's pretty heavy.
Oh, God, you're telling me. Oh, my life. And I'm following them. I don't even know I'm coming.
They don't know?
No. He's probably screwing her right now in some motel room.
Nah. I don't think so. I mean, why? Why would he?
What do you mean?
Why? I mean, look at you. He'd be nuts.
That was sweet, thanks.
So do you have any kids with, Ben?
Show you something.
Yeah.
It's your son.
My name's Vince.
It's a beautiful boy.
Yes, that he was. He got sick a little over a year ago. And he died.
I'm sorry.
We don't talk about it, me and Ben. You know, I haven't even said his name since the funeral.
Claire. What's his name?
You want to know his name?
I want to know your son's name.
Do this to you.
Welcome to the Rock Creek Motel.
How are you?
Fill out this registration card. I'll be with you in a sec.
Okay. I need a room with two beds if you have it.
Well, that's going to cost you $86.50 plus tax.
Fine, I don't care.
That lady out there with you?
Yes, why?
Well, she's buck naked by the pool.
Do you have a towel?
Remember that time I went skinny dipping in Lake Ballard? I think that's when it happened.
And what happened?
When I fell in love with you.
Thank you.
done?
There was this woman with one item, broccoli, and she wanted to cut in front of me in line, and she was wearing nursing shoes.
I said, no, and she said, no, and I said, no, and then I punched her, and they tried to arrest me, but I escaped and disappeared into the teddy bear lounge, and that night I let a man fuck me that I didn't know, and we listened to Christmas carols on the radio. On the way home, I tried to suck the light out of the stars.
Lulu.
I know, Ben. My mind is broken, you know? And I've got a glitch in my ganglia, but the naked truth is that I would just like to learn how to jet ski before I die, that's all. I would love to have my own apartment, and I would love to paint a rainbow on the wall, and I would love to learn how to play the guitar, and I'd like to shotgun down an avalanche, and... oh, I would love to stand in the shadows of the Rock of Gibraltar.
Lulu. I need to ask you something, and I need you to tell me the truth. Are you taking your medication?
What medication?
Your pills. Are you taking them?
My risperdal. My lithium and my serotonin levels are doing just fine, so don't worry about me or my state of mind, Mr. Clifton. Can I ask you something?
Sure.
Why didn't you come and visit me in the hospital? Why? Dan, please tell me.
I did, Lulu. I came to see you every day after class for a week. And they had you in a locked ward with your arms and legs strapped to the bed, and you had no idea who I was.
They told me that you didn't call.
I begged them not to tell you.
Why? Why?
I was afraid. I was afraid that you would always be sick and that our lives could never be the same.
I wish that you would have called me once, you know? Or written me a letter. Because I missed you so much. You know?
Yes, I do. I'm sorry, Lulu. I'm so sorry.
Maybe we should just stop and go back home.
No.
Why?
We've come too far. This is our son that you've carried around in your heart for over 16 years. There's no way we're turning around.
Do you really want to see him?
With all my heart.
If I get my hands on what my eyes see, my whole mind and body will be trouble-free. I see what I want, know what I need. Baby, please, say to me, I wish you could and be good if you could.
Handsome and smart like you.
No doubt.
And tall like me.
Hello.
Hey, Ben. What's the deal, man? Where the hell are you?
Hey, Clark. How's it going, bud?
How's it going? How's it going? You were waiting on you. You promised me just Wednesday. Remember, where the hell are they?
Well, you know, I just haven't had a chance to get to it. What can I say? Something came up.
I can't believe I'm hearing this.
Yeah?
Crap.
Well... We all gotta do what we all gotta do, I guess.
Listen to me. I'm calling your agent. I'm gonna personally make sure you never step foot on this lot again. You are dead in this town.
Have a nice life. Good luck, sweetheart. Oh, no. Sweetheart, you just witnessed the end of my TV career.
Next week, though. I'm so sorry. Thank you. Thank God for answering machines.
How can I help you?
Yes, I have a reservation. Claire Clifton.
Clifton, okay.
Has Ben Clifton checked in yet?
No, it doesn't look like it, but I'll get you all squared away.
God, wow. Look, it's amazing, isn't it? It looks exactly the same.
Serious blast from the past. It's incredible.
Remember when we sat right over there? You brought me to dinner here. You were trying to impress me with our third date. You wanted to get me in bed.
Room 1108. I'll have your bags brought right up to your room.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Are you gonna get us a room?
Good idea. Claire.
Hello, Ben.
What are you doing here?
I don't know, it just felt like taking a little trip. Do something impulsive for a change. Always advising that to my patients.
Anyway, I wanted to see what all the fuss was about.
Who's she?
I'm Ben's wife. Claire Clifton.
No, you're not. Ben's wife lives in L.A. Who is this person?
She is my wife.
You told her to come here?
No, I did not tell her to come here.
Well, then what is she doing here?
It was my idea. Thought maybe that I could watch our marriage disintegrate up close.
Oh, really? What marriage?
Exactly.
Jane Clifton.
You can't be here. You're not supposed to be here. You should just go back home. Tell her, Ben. Tell her.
Tell her what? I can't do that, Lulu.
Excuse me. Miss?
God damn it! No wonder you write for fucking television! I mean, Jack Kerouac, he would never have married a uptight bitch like this.
Charming, Ben. Was she always this rude?
She looks like Martha Stewart.
Oh, God.
Who the hell do you think you are? Huh?
Oh, please stop.
Huh?
You know, he may have married you, but he loved me first. Didn't you?
What are you doing?
Nothing. It's true, isn't it? Ben? Tell her, Ben.
Yes, I loved you first, okay? Can we take this out of this lobby?
You can stay now if you want.
You did what?
You broke the sixth commandment? Oh my God, I'm gonna have to pray for your soul right here. Please forgive her for being such a slut. She really didn't mean it.
Oh, you let me get this. You just did it with a perfect stranger.
Yeah.
Why?
Why, Ben? I don't know. Maybe because I felt like it.
And you just couldn't wait to get here to tell me about it, could you?
What's happening in my life?
Damn it!
What the fuck are you doing?
Really angry.
Good.
No. He didn't cheat on you. I mean, I tried everything that I could to get him to cheat on you, but he wouldn't. I just like might like to know that. Ooh. And also now you're probably feeling very sorry. Regret setting in, remorse. I'm sure you feel really guilty.
Shut up!
Guilty, 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 guilty.
Yes, I feel guilty, okay? Are you happy? God. This is ridiculous. What am I even doing in this room with you?
You have an awful lot of pent-up anger, don't you? You must be an awful therapist.
I am an excellent therapist.
How about if I be the judge of that? You should go talk to Ben.
Oh, really? Do you have any more advice? Maybe you'd like to be our marriage counselor.
Did you know that sometimes I ask my pillow late at night, how much sadness do I have to feel? And did you know that love is the world's greatest painkiller? And Marilyn Monroe wore a mask of tragedy over her pubic hair.
Should go talk to Ben.
Why didn't you and Ben ever have any kids? Was it because you were too busy with your practice? Too busy being a doctor? I mean, we know that he's not impotent, that's for sure.
No, he's not.
What? Why are you looking at me like that?
Ben and I did have a child. A son. He died of leukemia last year. He was 5. I'm surprised Ben didn't tell you.
That's absurd. She never mentioned a son to me. I mean, obviously she was hallucinating.
No, it is not a hallucination, and it's not a lie. Trust me.
All right, and you've spoken to the adoptive parents. They know that you're coming.
Yes, we're going to see them tomorrow morning, and they know everything. Okay. All right. Hold on. Now what? No, not you. What were you saying? Hey, I've got a great idea. My loving wife is here who happens to be a shrink. You guys should have a great time jerking each other off.
Excuse me. And who is that?
Hello? Lulu's therapist. Knock yourself out. I'm gonna get drunk.
Hello, this is Dr. Clifton.
Hey, Lulu. It's me. Open up.
No, don't rape at me. I'm fine. I'm just a girl with scarred wrists. Can't sit still.
Lulu, open the door, please.
Ben, she's off her medication.
I know this, Claire. Do you have your key?
No.
Listen.
No, I don't want my fucking medication. I don't want any medication because my medication makes me feel nowhere, and I don't like to feel nowhere because that's no fun. I mean, I would like to break windows. I would like to smash glasses.
She's breaking down, man.
I mean, who gives a fuck if the kitchen knives look really friendly?
Lulu! Lulu, please open up!
Lulu, open up!
Can't we just close our eyes and count backwards and let the rain fall on our faces?
Lulu, please open up! Please! Okay, all right. I'll get the key. You get the prescription.
Claire, get on a plane and go home. Maybe you'll get lucky again. Lulu, open this door!
Lulu McAfee is a 38-year-old single white female who's been hospitalized over 30 times for attempted suicide and self-mutilation. At night, she can be belligerent. She does not like loud noises. Sometimes she feels a thorn in her foot where there is no thorn. And then she stumbles and she nearly tumbles until she reaches out and a stranger's hand holds her.
You betrayed me, Claire. You fucking betrayed me!
I know you're angry with me. But she needs supervision, okay?
I have supervised her very well for 2,000 miles. Excuse me, could you open the door? We locked ourselves out of the room.
I understand that.
Hurry, please.
Things are a little different right now, Ben. She's about to see her son for the very first time tomorrow, and that...
You're forgetting something here, Claire. He's my son, too. Lulu?
Lulu?
Hey.
Hey, are you okay? Yeah.
Is there anything... Talk to you? I tried that constantly. But you put your pain in some pretty little bow-tied box that I can't touch. You obviously buried any love you had for me with it.
need to talk about this.
What do you want from me?
I want you to tell me.
Tell you what?
Tell me about your son.
Tell you how much I hate it. That everywhere I look, I see his face. In the clouds, in the windshield, and the blank page in my typewriter. And then other times, I can't see him at all and it kills me. Is that what you want? Or how about, the fact that I feel like I'm dying inside and there's not a goddamn thing I can do about it. I just can't stop hearing his voice. I'm in the mall and jogging in the park and I hear him say, you're fun, Daddy. He used to say that all the time when we were horsing around. You're fun, Daddy, you're fun, Daddy, you're fun, Daddy.
You're fun, Daddy, you're fun, Daddy. That's good. What was his name?
Died with him. Now I have some son and I know already knows it all and he's not going to be interested in anything I have to say.
You don't know that.
You think he cares about us?
Maybe and maybe not, but we can let him know that we care.
We're gonna see him, Lulu.
Claire, I think I need my medication.
This kid's parents gotta have some bucks.
Yeah, nice neighborhood. Ben, I think you should pull over.
No, it's 2:16. We're not there.
Yeah,
it's next
I know.
Block.
But, Lulu has something to tell you before we get there. So, can you pull over now?
This is Eric. Linda Davis is from Valley View, you know? And when we called the parents, that wasn't the parents, that was Freddie. And Freddie's at Valley View. He's crazier than I am, that's for sure. And you were right, I did forge the birth certificate.
What are you trying to tell me?
I'm trying to tell you that, I lied, that this is not our son.
He's not our son. You have bullshit me for 2,000 miles?
No. Yes. I mean, sort of.
Don't,
but
don't even,
finished.
Don't talk, do not,
Ben.
Do not talk,
Ben,
Lulu.
Ben, let her speak.
Ben.
What are you trying to do to me?
Nothing.
I can't take this anymore. Look, I've got a son. I don't have a son. I have a son. I don't have a... What is this? Fuck with Ben Week?
Ben! Listen to her.
Look, and what about you? If you want to get rid of me, I'll do it for you. How's that?
Ben! Whoa, wait a minute.
We have a son. We have a son.
I have a son.
Yes, we have a son. This is not him. This is Eric.
Why didn't you tell me this earlier before I made a complete ass out of myself?
Because I was afraid that you wouldn't come with me.
So what's in your head? You think we're literally gonna show up at this kid's house as his biological parents? Hey, here's mommy and daddy. After 16 years, we're here to screw with your life.
Ben, Lulu told me about this last night. I have contacted the parents, and they have agreed, as long as it's okay with Martin, your son.
Okay.
All right, so we're gonna go, all right?
I have to retime.
They're taking the time off.
Where are my glasses? Did I break them?
I don't know. You threw them out.
They went that way.
Did you find them?
Yes.
Where does he live?
216 Elm Street.
It's the same address, Ben.
We're on Elm Street. It's up there. There.
Millie? They're here. Upstairs and ask Martin to come down. What? What? We've discussed this. We've come to an agreement. It's the right thing to do.
But for who? There's a dozen excuses we can make. We could say that he was at band practice.
I'm not going to talk about this. They're outside and they're coming in. Stop it. Stop it. Okay? Martin?
All you have to do is just be yourself.
Just be you.
Yep.
I can do that, I guess.
You ready?
Are you ready? Take your glasses off.
Oh. Okay.
Okay. Does anyone want to ring the bell?
The bell?
Ben, the doorbell?
Oh.
Martin.
Hi. Ben.
Hi.
Your father.
Lulu.
Your mother.
Nice to meet you.
This is Claire, Ben's wife.
Oh, the shrink, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Sorry.
It's okay. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah, congratulations. 16. That's a big one.
A big one?
Well, get to drive and all, you know.
I've been driving since I was 14.
Oh, I didn't know.
Oh, that's right. You don't know anything about me.
You're right, I know.
But he wants to. We want to.
Sorry, I was just trying to be friendly.
Nice try. Well, come in.
Okay.
Now, this is a little short notice.
Yeah.
Mom, Dad, this is Lulu.
Hi.
Jerome.
Nice to meet you.
Millie.
Hi.
Hello.
And that's Ben.
Jerome, my wife, Millie. Jerome.
Hi. Nice to meet you. And this,
Claire.
Claire.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. Oh, that's okay. I think we're all pretty nervous right now.
No kidding. Boy, out there, my heart was pounding so fast that it was gonna pop. It was going boom, 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 you know? Like I was on death row or something. But now that Martin let us in, I feel much better. I may not sound like I feel better, but it's better, no? And now I talk really fast. But, you know, you're so handsome.
you were just trying to be affectionate.
Yeah. Maybe we shouldn't rush things.
I wasn't trying to rush anything.
Why don't, why don't we sit down?
It's a lovely home.
Thank you.
Could I get anyone some iced tea or lemonade?
Oh, man, I could use a glass of white wine.
We don't serve alcohol, I'm sorry.
Oh, iced tea would be great. Yeah.
Tea's fine.
You don't serve alcohol?
Neither one of us drinks.
Oh, are you alcoholics?
No.
Yes. Yes, I'm an alcoholic.
Wow. I used to drink a lot when I was in college, but I was never that bad.
So you're a writer?
No. You're a writer? A lot of mentally ill people have alcoholic.
My mom is not mentally ill.
I was saying that's not what I meant.
Claire said that you write for television.
You did it again. You're doing it again. You interrupted me.
Did I?
Twice.
I'm sorry.
No, you're not. I mean, I would just like to be able to finish one sentence.
Say you were sorry.
Oh, okay. So now you're on his side. Well, I guess that you would be because this is your house and you live together.
Thank you.
So that makes it.
I'll be right back.
Together.
Breathe.
Sorry I'm late.
It's all right.
Hey, Mrs. Ellsworth.
Hello.
Mrs. Ellsworth.
Hello, I'm Claire.
Hi, I'm his girlfriend.
Oh, Ben.
Ben.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Lulu.
Hi, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
You write for Magnetic North? That's a really cool show.
Oh, thank you.
Ben was actually nominated for an Emmy twice.
Lost both times, but...
Martin writes...
Poetry, actually. He writes poetry.
Really? I'd love to read something.
Why?
Oh, no, you should show them, Martin. They're really cool. He had a bunch published in our student newspaper.
Just and...
okay. No, well, I would love to see you writing, Ben. I know who to.
I'd rather not.
Why are you so negative? Can't you be a little bit more open? A little bit?
Martin is extremely open. He barely knows you. Or Ben, and I think there are some things that he would rather keep to himself.
Well, that's understandable. I mean, we all can relate to that. Can't we, Ben?
Well, I could relate a lot more if you could find a way to lighten up just a little bit.
I would think that you would be a little more understanding, considering you're the one that put him in this situation.
Really?
Can Martin not speak for himself? You can, can't you? All we did was ask to see some of your writing. Ben is a writer, too.
Yes, you've already mentioned the writing. But
really?
We've come a long way to see you, to try to get to know you. Maybe learn to like us.
Well, I didn't ask you to come back. I didn't ask you to come back into my life. Did I? Did I, Ben?
No, Martin, you didn't. But let's face it, you wouldn't even be on the planet if it weren't for me and Lulu.
What?
It's a fact.
Well, so now you, after 16 years, you're gonna come back and want to take credit? Man, that's bullshit! What? If I ever have a kid, I'm not just gonna blow off any responsibility and just leave him.
Look, obviously, there's not a thing we can do or say that is not going to set you off, is there?
All they're trying to do is to come here and just meet their son.
All right. Well, I'm not it. Okay? You're not my dad. He's my dad. She's my mom. And she's just crazy.
That's not fair, Martin.
What? What? I mean, look at her!
All right, Martin, that's
not the way. No, he's right. They give us one night's notice after 16 years?
Okay.
How did you think
that he was going to react? That's enough. Did you think about that at all?
Why
do we let them do
that? Okay, that's enough.
You know what? None of you are interested at all in giving us a chance here, are you? We know how difficult this has got to be for you, but it's hard for us too, okay? You have any idea what this woman has gone through, to the courage it took for her to get here over 2,000 miles? She was bringing all the love she has to you, knowing that you wouldn't be able to give it back right away. I think you owe her an apology.
Find her?
No, she's gone. Claire, let's go.
I'm sorry. Martin's really a wonderful kid. You know, give it some time and you'll learn that.
Oh, God, where could she be?
I think I know where she is. So let's go.
I'd like to come with you.
Let's go.
Go in alone.
Martin.
It'll be all right.
Okay.
Why did you do that?
I want to see what kind of day it is.
They like any of that. Come. Go.
Give me a try.
What time is it?
7 o'clock. Leave that later.
Why?
Why?
Listen, I'm really sorry about what I said earlier. You know, I didn't mean it. I know you're not crazy.
Oh, yeah, I am. I accept it. You know, you should too. Makes things a lot easier.
Give me a shave. There's nothing out looking.
What'd you have to say that for, Sarah?
How do you know my name is Sarah?
Told.
I lied. When I'm drunk, I lie.
Okay, so what's your name today?
How many times have you seen this?
A lot. It was Ben's favorite first, and then it was mine. We had a lot of fun together, me and Ben. We had big fun. For a while, we were so close that we shared one heart. Ben would have made a terrific dad, don't you think?
I don't know, you know, maybe.
Martin, he never knew that I had a baby. I never told him until a few days ago.
Okay.
I got troubles, Eddie. I think you got troubles. Maybe it'd be better if we didn't see each other for a while. You know, I could never have raised you, you know. I was too sick. And I knew that one day we would see each other. I knew that for sure.
I'm really glad that you came.
Sorry.
Shh. Please be quiet while the movie's playing.
I'm not sure.
Okay.
So there are people who are always looking for an excuse to look. What did you do? The gamble.
You win
it?
Is that what makes a winner?
But what else does?
You guys okay?
Yeah.
You know, someday, Sarah, you're going to settle down. You're going to marry a college professor. You're going to write a great book. Maybe about me.
Excuse us, sorry. Excuse us.
What's wrong?
I don't know about this.
About what?
I just think I should go with you. Lulu, I need to...
We did it, you know. We found our boy. Thank you. We went all the way.
I've always loved you.
I always will. Always. Which route are you taking home?
The only one we haven't taken, the northern route.
Cheyenne.
Mm-hmm.
Rockies.
Mm-hmm.
Be beautiful.
Bye, Lulu.
FedEx for Lulu McAfee.
That's me.
Well, here we go.
Thank you. To Lulu, took me on one more ride with the top down.